Hey everybody, welcome to Jersey Craft Beer Review, episode number 8. For those of you that like an IPA, we got a great one for you this week. It's Rake Breaker from Jersey Girl Brewing Company in Hackettstown. With me as always, my compadres, Chris Anucci, Dan Tantillo. Gentlemen, what do we got this week? What are we looking at?
So this is a tropical New England style IPA, 6.17% APV. The IBU, not available on their website, but we'd guess around 60, maybe under 60. It's made with Mosaic and Amarillo, hazy, fresh, and incredibly drinkable. It's a tornado of tropical hops, and it will be sure, according to the website, to break your perception of traditional bitter IPAs.
Ooh, I'm excited.
It's a bold statement.
Just for the fact that they called it a tornado,
yeah,
I like that.
Do you like tornadoes?
Dangerous. Well, apparently not when you're drinking.
Like drinking tornadoes, but not being in them.
Exactly. We got to specify that.
Yeah, so this is Jersey Girl Brewing Company, opened in 2014. So another pretty new brewery, but it feels like they're been around a while.
Seniors.
And they're called Jersey Girl, but it's two dudes. Two guys open this. So
that's awesome.
Originally, I was like, oh, it's cool, you know, girl or, you know, female brewers. And, you know, but they just named the company after that. They're inspired by the Jersey Girl.
No girl like a Jersey Girl. That's the truth.
People have written songs about them.
Yes, they have.
So I think that's pretty interesting. This has, they mentioned the oats in the malt. So I don't know if I've ever had an IPA that has focused on oats.
It's or usually, at least something that's even described in the description. Yeah.
I'm sure that they're in there, but...
You never see it as like the focal
point. Yeah, so I'm curious about this one. So why don't we get into it and check the color? What do you guys call this one?
This orangey, kind of yellow-orange.
Yeah. Almost like apricot.
Yep.
Like a slight peach yellow.
A little bit.
Right, nice foamy white head. You smell. Oh, it smells good.
Yeah.
Tropical fruit.
Definitely fruity.
Yeah, I definitely get the melon.
Yep.
And like papaya and mango and stuff.
It smells like summer.
Yeah, more tropical fruit than like citrus.
Yes.
You know, I think there's definitely more fruit than there is citrus in there. And I'm getting like maybe a little bit of like a tea.
Yeah. Like a, could see
like
it.
Like a herbal tea.
Yeah, herbal.
Or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It smells delicious.
Let's get into this one.
Yes, absolutely.
Look forward to it. Yeah. Wow.
Definitely different for an IPA, I gotta say right off the bat.
Yeah. It's not.
Definitely different.
It's not that citrus hop
punch. Nope.
That's almost not even there.
Yeah.
And it's very like, it's kind of like sweet too for an IPA.
Very sweet. Yeah, it's still drinkable though. But it's, again, yeah, it's like you guys were saying, it doesn't necessarily fit the standout description of an IPA that you're used to.
Definitely not.
It's very muted. So like, even for an IPA, I think like it's almost hard to categorize it as that.
Yeah,
it's
kind of
its own really thing. Is.
It doesn't have necessarily the aftertaste that a lot of APAs would have. Yeah. Very curious.
There's something else in there too. I guess like the oats maybe are bringing in a little like breadiness.
Yeah.
A little bit. Yeah, I could definitely see that.
Like dough, like a pasta dough. Or like a pizza dough.
Pizza dough. More, yeah.
You know, you smell of pizza dough?
Yes.
That's definitely in there. Really interesting.
Yeah.
Really interesting stuff. So, I think it says it on the can. We should probably read the can. But it does. So, this brew broke their lauter tun rake. So, it's like the big tank where they're getting the wort out of the beer, you know, in the beer making process. And they have that rake that spins everything.
It's the rake breaker.
So, I think on their first brew, it broke because there's so much grain in there. And that's where it got the name. So it's kind of pretty cool.
Speaking of the can, it says it right there. Ain't nothing in the world like a Jersey Girl beer. I didn't even see that.
That's their logo.
It's great.
All right, cool. So we'll let this warm up and see how it changes and everything. We'll be back with our final thoughts in just a bit.
And we're back. Jersey Craft Beer Review, Episode 8. We're talking Rake Breaker IPA beer. Guys, I think we're all very surprised at this one.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think that this is like any IPA. Like, if you were to tell me that this was an IPA and poured the glass, I wouldn't have necessarily believed you. It doesn't have any of the main IPA characteristics that you normally think of, but that's not a bad thing.
Yeah.
It's more tropical than it is citrusy. It's still incredibly drinkable. It tastes like I said before, it tastes like summer. Imagine the season, that's what it tastes like.
Yeah.
But it's a really different kind of IPA that I've ever had. I think I definitely would want to try this again just because I still am not used to really the flavors altogether. I don't know, but I mean, this was something completely different for me.
I really think it's a great summer. It's weird to say summer IPA, but it's sweet. It's kind of fruity, but not. It doesn't overpower you with sweet.
Yeah.
Like it doesn't. It if you're not into the sweet thing, this isn't gonna overpower you, but you'll enjoy it anyway. Because I don't really like when it gets into the like being over fruity, if that makes sense. But I really, this is just a good balance, but it really gonna be an enjoyable summer drink for sure.
Yeah, I think there's not a lot like this, at least of what we had so far. But you know, like you're saying, like the summer style and stuff, like IPAs are a great summer beer as well. But I think this takes it just a step further.
Yeah,
and it's got to be the oats addition that's changing it. And it's just they don't really hop it that much, or so, you know, dry hop it. So it's just, it's very unique, it's very drinkable and sweet, and it's really interesting.
Yeah, I think if you're going into it, if you're going for an IPA based on something that you've normally drank before, this may not be necessarily the one to go to just to get that normal IPA taste, but I'm telling you, you have one sip of this and you're going to be curious to the point where you want two or three more just so you can figure out everything that this beer has to offer.
Yeah,
so like, I mean, the IPA style was... It's like an old style, so it was created to survive the trip to India to be sold, right? So I don't even know if, like, this qualifies. I mean, I guess it does qualify as an IPA. Like, what am I to say?
Yeah, right.
But I would put it in a totally new category of something that we haven't had before.
Absolutely, for sure.
Definitely.
So definitely try this one. Really cool beer.
Yeah, for sure. It's brewed in Hackettstown, New Jersey. Again, this is Rake Breaker IPA by Jersey Girl Brewing Company. You can pick up growlers at the brewery. It is also on tap at Jack's Gold Line Stand in Long Branch, Ott's in Medford, and the Station Bar and Grill in Garwood. And for more information, you can visit their website and their Facebook page somewhere
in the universe.
Somewhere there.
All right. Well, that was Jersey Craft Beer Review, Episode 8, Rake Breaker from Jersey Girl Brewing Company. For myself, Chris Swenderman, Chris Anucci, Dan Tantillo, thanks again for watching. Cheers.
Cheers.